Class of 2021, it is my pleasure to welcome you to graduation week. We have a lot of great programs planned for you, including Dean Howie's keynote, Trivia Tuesday with Tyler, War in the World hosted by Sloan. You'll hear speeches from B. Tran, Toyin Ogedenbe, Shamir Sangrajka. We will announce the class awards. You'll hear from your graduation student speaker, Khaled Alshawi, and Kamna Katharia will deliver her WJ address. We'll end the week with our vice deans conducting name roll call. Make sure you visit mbastudentlife.upenn.edu for scheduled events, links, and all the recordings if you missed a session. Now, it is my true and utmost pleasure to introduce the Vice Dean of the MBA program, Howard Kaufeld. Since many of us took his corporate finance class, we know him as Professor Howie, or better referred to as the Colossus of CAPM, the NPV of NPV, or our true favorite, Dean Howie. Dean Howie, on behalf of the class of 2021, I'd like to recognize and thank you for your leadership and dedication to building and strengthening the MBA student experience during our 2 years here at Wharton.
Thank you, Michael. And greetings, members of the MBA class of 2021, and your partners, family members, and friends. Today, we come together virtually to applaud your outstanding achievements, both inside and outside the classroom. And these achievements are even more remarkable, given the environment that you weathered while pursuing your MBA. Looking back at the past 2 years that you spent in the program, I imagine that it feels like you lived through two very different and momentous chapters during your Wharton tenure. Chapter one began in August 2019, when, full of anticipation, you relocated to Philadelphia to start classes, make friends, get involved in clubs and activities, and explore your new city. Then in March 2020, just before spring break, life as we knew it shut down in response to the global pandemic. This abrupt close to your first chapter scattered your class across the globe. Some of you hunkered down in your Philly apartments, others headed back home across the US or overseas, wherever you could stay safe from COVID-19. 2 weeks later, after spring break, chapter two of your journey began with the new reality of distance learning and strict health protocols. Our campus enclave had dispersed into fragments that had to be reconfigured to bring us back together as a new entity. Faculty and staff had to invent new ways of delivering the MBA program, and you had to suddenly adapt to virtual classrooms, as well as physical separation from your Wharton classmates and friends. Through the summer of 2020, while the pandemic intensified, there were other cataclysmic events. Racial justice protests that began in the spring continued to bring long-standing inequalities and discrimination to everyone's attention and rippled through our institutions and conversations. At the same time, a fiercely divisive election campaign was being waged. In response, many of you organized, donated, volunteered, and marched for social justice and to get out the vote. In the fall, when your second year began, the health crisis continued to impede our ability to be together on campus, to travel, and to reunite with loved ones. And sadly, many of us lost family members and friends. In spite of these setbacks, you adapted and innovated to recreate community at work. Clubs and activities transformed into virtual entities. The leaders of Storytellers, Miriam Wakar and Kartik Kacholia, moved the group to a new stage on Zoom, enabling hundreds of students to hear their classmates' inspiring tales of overcoming challenges in their lives. With gyms closed, Bridget O'Carroll and Stephanie McCaffrey led workouts, and Jillian Dunzang taught classmates yoga and meditation to stay calm and carry on. Femi Brinson and Erica Williams partnered with CAPS to promote wellness within the Black student community. And Samantha Shafrank and others created an interfaith club as a spiritual outlet for classmates from diverse religious backgrounds. Other students were inspired to develop startups to help the wider community. Ben Berman channeled his love of pizza making into pie sales and social media attention, raising thousands of dollars for Philadelphia homeless shelters and food pantries. Divya Balaji passed up a traditional summer internship and instead created a venture to support desperately needed women's health services in India. And a group of Wharton students volunteered with the New York City Department of Small Business Services to translate COVID relief documents into 10 different languages. These are just a few examples of how your resilience and determination in the face of unprecedented obstacles carried us through as a community to the finish line today. While I know that the disruptions and adversity you faced these past months have been challenging and exhausting, I am also confident that you'll look back on this period as one of great personal growth and strength. Now, fortified with the Wharton MBA, you are well equipped as problem solvers, innovators, and leaders to re-enter a work world that has changed irrevocably. We at Wharton have been greatly enriched by your presence and are grateful for the many ways that you have contributed to the intellect, character, and heart of our program. My faculty and staff colleagues join me in wishing you our very best for your next chapter. Congratulations. We're also looking forward to seeing you at the Class of 2021 celebratory events this entire week. So let me now turn it back to Michael, and you'll hear more. Thank you.
Thank you, Dean Howie, for your thoughts to kick off our graduation week. To everybody on the call, we look forward to seeing you at this week's events to continue the celebration.
There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feels like December when somebody say your name, cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day, hey. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday.